Hello and welcome to the Daily Transcript Newsroom. In local business news, the county's Board of Supervisors voted Tuesday to begin using an electronic verification system called E-Verify on all its new employees. The system goes into effect next month and is used to stop illegal immigrants from landing county jobs. The supervisors also voted to send a letter to Congress supporting a bill that will clear the way for a county rooftop solar program. The program was blocked by a federal agency last year. And George Chamberlain writes about a unique fraud case reported on the Securities and Exchange Commission's website involving the SEC and a deaf man. The man is accused of defrauding thousands of hearing-impaired investors. In real estate news, two residential properties and a parking lot on Ivanhoe Road in La Jolla were sold for $5.9 million. On Wall Street, despite choppy trading during the day, stocks scored strong gains by the market's close. The Dow was up by almost 45, the Nasdaq by 37, and the S&P 500 by over 10.5 points. On Wednesday, the Commerce Department releases retail sales for August, the Labor Department releases the Producer Price Index for August, and the House Energy and Commerce Subcommittee will hold a hearing on Solyndra, a California solar panel manufacturer that received more than $500 million in federal loans before filing for bankruptcy. For complete coverage of our stories, check out the rest of SDDT.com. I'm Claire Chegasser, and thanks for clicking.